Hare Krishna devotees, Prabhuji's and Mataji's, today's welcome to the today's session. Let us pray to Sri Sri Radha Govindji and also seek the blessings of His Grace, Sri Namnist Prabhuji, the temple president is Kulai, Iskon Temple, Kulai, Bangalore. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjan Shalakya Chakshurun Meelitamena Tasmai Shri Gurubhe Namah Om Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Peshtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedant Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gaurvani Pracharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschat Deshatarini Jayo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advait Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakti Vrinda He Krishna Karna Sindhu Deenvandhu Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Shri Radha Kanta Namostute Tapt Kanchan Gaurangi Shri Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanusute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna devotees. So we'll quickly review the last verse we covered in the last session. The performing prescribed duty is better than not performing anything. That is, renunciation is not good. You must perform as prescribed duties. And prescribed duties, if they are performed, they lead to gradual purification of heart. And if there is renunciation, fall down since activity is given up before purifying the heart. That means one who is a renunciate, he must perform prescribed duty first, get his heart purified, then he can only proceed for renunciation. A person who has got desires in his mind or desires in heart and has got material entanglement, and before removing them, if he takes up sannyas, then he becomes a nuisance to the society, right? So, but Arjuna here was a grihasth, he was a kshatriya also, so he should be engaged in a war and he should not go to forest. That is, he should not believe in renunciation. He should work in as per prescribed duty. And for him, the prescribed duty was nishkam karma. Work should not be given up capriciously without purification of materialist propensities. Capriciously means suddenly, unexpectedly, because person is not ready for it. He has still impurities in his heart. Yes, Chanda Mataji, may you please continue.
Prabhuji, I wanted to ask here something.
Yeah.
We are talking about the duties, right? So, as per the Varna Ashrama system, we have four categories. Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasi. So, as per the each stage, the prescribed duty is like Brahmacharya means Brahmacharya. What are the duties? To earn the knowledge and be in discipline. Making oneself discipline in that point of time when we are in Brahmacharya. Then when we are coming into the Grihastha, then prescribed duty will be the looking after the family and all those action we have to perform. So stage by stage, the prescribed duty is changing. So as per the Arjuna, now he is a warrior. So at this stage, his duty is to fight, not to quit. And I got confused in here because I have gone through this dharma, the duties. It is divided into two parts. So one is samanya dharma and one is the vishesha dharma. So we were talking about swadharma and spiritual dharma. Right, Prabhuji?
Yes, Prabhuji.
So the vishesha dharma is a spiritual dharma. Samanya dharma, though all of us we follow generally, right? And vishesha dharma, the spiritual dharma will come into vishesha dharma where we have specific personal duties like we have kula dharma, manav dharma, then swadharma, rajya dharma, then praja dharma. And one more, we have Varna Dharma. So actually, I'm not able to understand this spiritual dharma, where it falls at which category, like two types are there, samanya and vishesha.
We have to go by what Srila Prabhupada has mentioned in Bhagavad Gita as it is, firstly. Secondly, so far as duties are prescribed, duties are concerned, they are prescribed for each varna. Varna stands for Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudra. These are four varnas. So these have got specific duties to perform. Like, for example, I'll tell you, for Brahmana, it is a duty of to study scriptures, to spread the scriptural knowledge or transcendental knowledge to each and everyone, right?
Yes.
To perform, some kind of certain religious activities. These are nine activities. Now, second aspect, these are varna-based prescribed duty, then ashram-based prescribed duty, like Brahmacharya ashram, the celibacy and study of the scriptures, that is his duty during the Brahmacharya. Similarly, for grihas, for grihaspa, then thereafter, vanaprastha, and there also sannyas. So the prescribed duties are related to each varna and each ashram. So right, and there are two types of dharma. One is swadharma, and other is adhyatmik dharma or spiritual dharma. Swadharma refers to is a group heading of all the prescribed duties. Swadharma means all duties which are prescribed in whatever varna ashram one is. And spiritual duties, these duties are so dharma are to be performed when person is alive in his material body. And the spiritual, the adhyatmic dharma or spiritual dharma that begins when one leaves this material body and reaches transcendental, then he has another duty towards that in that particular loka or whatever, wherever he is, right? So
for the liberation of the soul, we are working in the spiritual dharma.
No, spiritual dharma begins after you have left this body. So prescribed duties in either varna or ashram are basically the duties which leads one to the path of liberation or to the path of Krishna consciousness and thereby liberation. Right. So is it clear now?
Yes, Prabhupada. Yes.
Prescribed duty are referred to certain specific activities that must be performed by a person when he is in a particular varna or ashrama, right? And for each it is classified. Like for Shudra, his duty is to help all three varnas, number one, and to endeavor hard in whatever sphere he is, whether he is working as a construction labor, whether he is working in a field of agriculture, or whatever, that is his duty, right? And also assist all the three classes of people. These are socio-economic division of, they are not based on caste. But the one thing is,
Then Prabhuji, this like we are talking about Shudra, right? So his duty is also to transform himself, right? When he is in Shudra karma, when he is helping and helping other to with their duty, so it is his duty to transform himself as well, right? Upgrading.
Yeah, this is what I mentioned. The performance of prescribed duty leads to the knowledge ultimately, and knowledge leads to ultimately transcendence, knowledge of Krishna, and ultimately he also gets liberated. What happened with Haridas Thakur? Haridas Thakur belonged to a very low caste.
Yes.
Basically, initially he was not a Hindu, even a Hindu. So the purpose of all the dharmas, purpose of all the varnas and ashram is to elevate oneself to Krishna consciousness and get liberation from this. This human body has been given only for the purpose of self-realization, to know that I am not the body, I am the soul, and I have a relationship with Lord, and I have to go back to Him.
Yes.
So these are
Thank
the
you,
purposes. So we move on to this from this, because this has already been covered, discussed. Yes, 3.9. Chanda Mataji, you, and thereafter Richa Jain Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Mataji.
Yagya thata karmano anyatra loko up. कर्म बंधनः तदर्थं कर्म कौन्तेय मुक्त संगः समाचर. Work done as a sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed. Otherwise, work causes bondage in this material world. Therefore, O son of Kunti, perform your prescribed duty for his satisfaction, and in that way, you will always remain free from bondage. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So, yes, last session question was asked, what is the difference between Karma Yoga and Karma Kand? Karma Kand basically refers to the ritualistic activities which we perform, which Vedas recommend, right? And ritualistic activities are performed for bhog and aishwarya, for material gains, in other terms. Whereas Karma Yoga, it means karma, akarma or vikarma. Or akarma refers to nishkam karma also. Karma means prescribed duty. Karma Yoga, when we talk about karma, in Karma Yoga, it is our prescribed duties. And when the prescribed, we act totally against the, in contradiction to scriptural injunctions or the duties which are not mentioned in it, then they become vikarma. And akarma means what is being discussed here, nishkam karma. Akarma means activities performed without any attachment to the result or benefit of the actions. So these prescribed duties, which are karma, basically, they will definitely, incur some good or bad kind of reaction. But if all the reactions are offered to Lord, they are not used by the person or the devotee for self-sense gratification or for self-satisfaction or enjoyment, then they become nishkam karma. Because results are enjoyed by Lord Krishna, not by us or the devotee. So then they become akarma. They do not incur any kind of reaction. Now Krishna is telling Arjuna here that if you fight and kill these persons, then it will not incur any kind of sinful reaction on you. This is mentioned here. And if you perform your prescribed duties for his satisfaction, that is meant, because we perform yajna, yaj purush is Vishnu or in the form of Krishna. So he is the supreme enjoyer. We worship different kind of demigods during sacrifice, and these all sacrifice, all these worships are transmitted by demigods to whom we worship, to Supreme Personality of Godhead, who sanctions boons or benedictions that demigods provide are those benedictions. So what is mentioned here, that Arjuna, perform your prescribed duty for my satisfaction, basically. Now this is Krishna, what Krishna wants here to do. So now from Karma Kand to Karma Yoga, if a person is too attached, yes, Richa Jain Mataji, please read.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji.
If a person is too attached to material life and cannot perform Nishkam Karma Yoga, for them, Krishna describes the yoga ladder from lowest rung and gradually moving higher from Karma Kand to Karma Yoga. Srila Prabhupada ends all the purpose in section 3 by glorifying the supremacy and the need of Sankirtana Yagna.
So, thank you, Raji. So, it is mentioned here that one, if all of us are involved some or other kind of activities, we can't live. We have to act helplessly. And in the last session, it was mentioned that we have to act helplessly, working under the influence of three modes of material nature. Because we are bound by those three modes of material nature. So we have to rise from Karma Kand level to Karma Yoga. And in the Karma Yoga, three types of activities are described. One is karma, prescribed duty. Other is nishkam karma, that is, it results all of prescribed duties offered to Lord Krishna. And third is bikarma. We are not talking about bikarma here, right? So, but in this age or this period or Kali Yuga, the best Sankirtana Yajna is Sankirtana Yajna. So perform as a sacrifice to Vishnu or work causes bondage. So action performed for satisfaction of Vishnu or Krishna, they are not binding, they lead to liberation of individual because Krishna consciousness developed within his heart. And when we do these activity for under the spiritual guidance of the spiritual master, because you know association of pure devotees and it is following the instructions of the spiritual master is a pathway to achieving Krishna consciousness. So when we accept a guru or a spiritual master and work, we serve him lovingly, we obey his instructions, and we also work for his satisfaction, then gradually we are elevated to transcendental loving service of God. Because knowledge of Krishna is imparted by a spiritual master who is bona fide, who has come down from successive discipline. So then one can go to back to Godhead. But if one does otherwise, that is, if he does as a material activity, that all activities are material, they are performed with the intention of self-enjoyment or self-satisfaction, then there is a bondage. And the bondage, we keep on coming again into the cycle of birth and death. So this is the disadvantages here. Whether you do good action or bad action, in mode of goodness, passion or ignorance, everything is binding. And why binding? Now the question may come, why good activities are binding? Why they are not liberating? You know, we do a lot of charity work. We do a lot of keep fast, austerities and penance and so many other things. But, you know, these good activities also result in some kind of, you know, benefit or result. And this result is as consumed by us. For example, if we are doing donation, we feel inner happiness. We feel some kind of satisfaction or bliss. We do something, then we compare ourselves with others who have not done it or who are not doing it. We consider ourselves superior. So these effects, after effects of good actions, they are also binding. And they also lead us into the cycle of birth and death. So, but if we don't feel that it is my, if we consider ourselves just role of postman, that whatever is with us, if we share it with other person or give it to some other person, we have a conviction that it is not mine, it is Krishna's, and it is going to Krishna, then probably reaction will not occur. So this is the example given here. Sense, because there is senses are being satisfied, good section or bad section, so they are also even binding. So that has to be abandoned. That means everything has to be offer to Lord. So I will very quickly go through this. What does, you know, what activities distinguish human beings or us from animals? Does anybody remember from class level one? What are the four activities which are common in most of animals or people living animal life?
For the animals?
Yes, what are the four activities normally animals do?
Eating,
sleep, eat, and karma.
Defense.
Yeah, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending.
Defense.
So animals are doing these four activities. And most of the persons who are ignorant, who do not know Krishna consciousness, what are they doing? They are also enjoying life like this. They do not know there is a higher goal or purpose of life. They can get still, you know, higher perfection of life. So basic the activities performed by animals are eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. Everybody, we are always, most of us are also on the human beings are. Unless one has come into Krishna consciousness. So we are involved in karmakanda. From animal life, one has to, this is extended yoga ladder. How can we elevate our consciousness and our purpose of life, realize our purpose of life? That is through rising from animal life to karmakanda. And from karmakanda, sakarm karma yoga, that is fruitive activities, which give us some kind of benefit or results, to Nishkam Karma Yoga, and then from Nishkam Karma Yoga, we have to accumulate knowledge, that is Gyan Yoga, that is no work, and then go to Ashtang Yoga. And Ashtang Yoga, you know, has got eight limbs. And eight limbs are Yam Niyam Asan, Pranayam Pratyahar, and then dharana,
dhyana, dhyana,
samadhi,
samadhi.
Samadhi. So each step is very difficult to follow, and it takes thousands of years to be to get perfection in. So such person, you know, could develop mystic siddhis. Mystic siddhis, or mystic yogis, they can travel to from one place to another place. The body may remain at first place only. They can do many other mystic activities. So, but they are always lacking. Ultimately, they end up in the sun disk. They realize their realization from Jnana Yoga to Ashtanga Yoga to Bhakti Yoga is like the analogy of sun. We know if Jnana Yoga or a person whose knowledge or is limited to the sun rays only, that is Brahmanic effulgence, he considers merging into Brahmanic effulgence is ultimate goal of life. And there is no rasa, as I mentioned, that he is in a shant ras. He has no relationship with God. He does not accept God in a personal form or a bodily form. Then Ashtanga Yogi, they are slightly better because they have ultimately reached the sun disk. They know that the source of sunshine is the sun disk. But only Bhakti Yoga, person in Bhakti Yoga, he knows that there is something beyond sun disk, and that is sun god. He enters to find out what is there. And this is God form of realization. So this is Paramatma form of realization. This is Brahman effulgence form of realization of God. So ultimately, Bhakti Yoga, person who is in Bhakti Yoga, he is the highest knowledgeable person. This is extended. Now, we have a very short life and our memory is very short. Our ability to concentrate or meditate on anything is very, very, we are not able to follow the self-discipline, that is yama. We are not able, moral code of conduct, most of it is very difficult to follow these in work, material world. Then niyama, then postures, and thereafter your control of breath. All these things are impossible in this Kali Yuga. So extended yoga ladder is not recommended in this period. Then progressive yoga ladder. Progressive yoga ladder, sakam karma, nishkam karma, everything is almost common here. Animals, we know, have unrestricted sense gratification desires. They have no vivek, they don't have discrimination. They use their senses, whatever manner they want to fulfill and satisfy their senses, sense organs. Then karma can't regulated sense gratification. A person, he knows that it is good for my health, or what is good for my health, what is not good for my health. He controls his senses to this extent. But in Sakam Karma Yoga, selfish desires are there. In fact, when we are in grass, most of the times we are involved in Sakam Karma Yoga because we want results and results to satisfy our family members. In Nishkam Karma Yoga, that is where bhakti begins. Bhakti begins. And Bhakti, we talked about Bhakti, three forms of our Bhakti. Sadhana Bhakti, Bhava Bhakti, and Prema Bhakti. Nishkam Karma Yoga is devotees with no desire for personal interest. Whatever benefits or fruits accrue upon, doing activities, they are not enjoyed by the doer, but they are offered to Lord as his blessings, and he does not enjoy them. So that is Nishkam Karma Yoga. Then this is the beginning of Sadhana Bhakti. Now, bhakti, sadhana bhakti has got two forms. Vaidhi bhakti, where certain rules and regulations are followed, but there is no natural or spontaneous attachment or love for the Lord, right? So this is called vaidhi, because viti vaidhi, some rules and regulations are followed, or as per the scripture, or as per the orders of a spiritual master. So this is sadhana, vaidhi bhakti, vaidhi sadhana bhakti, and third is raganuga, sadhana bhakti. Raganuga sadhana bhakti, one develops some kind of raga or relationship or mellow with the Lord. He is in spontaneous love or attachment with Lord, and then this is called raganuga sadhana bhakti. From when this one person attains this thing, all his material desires go away, and he ultimately develops a bhava bhakti. That is called devotion in ecstasy. He is always thinking of Lord. He was never forgetting Lord. He is always in a bhav. How could I best do loving service to Lord Krishna? And ultimately, prema bhakti is developed lastly. So this is a ladder again. So yoga ladder, we see that this is also very complicated. We in our life is short, so perhaps we cannot pass from one stage to another in this life. So where come we have seen these two ladders, and last time we discussed about reaching a 10th floor by an elevator or a steps or a ramp. So everybody wanted to be very fast and reach the 10th floor. Everybody wanted elevator. So this this bhakti marg is the express elevator. It is express. It is not ordinary speed elevator, which we normally are used to. If we are going to very high floor, say 30th, 40th or 50th floor, the elevators are high speed elevators. So bhakti is the only elevator which is moving very fast, which can take us in this life to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, right? So the animal tendency all of us have, in fact, to some are greater or degree. But if from this animal tendency, if we surrender and associate with pure devotees, which is very, very important, this is the first step. If we come to know about Lord Krishna and we want to have association with our pure devotees who are working in this Krishna conscious movement or in the temples even, and we surrender to them, then we develop sadhana bhakti. A desire for serving Lord arises in our heart by virtue of their association. That is vedhi sadhana bhakti. Vedhi, when we perform daily, offer prasadam to Lord, do decoration at the temple or cleaning of temple or Tulsi Maharani puja, then we develop some kind of loving affection, love or affection for them. That becomes our Raganuga Bhakti. And from Raganuga Bhakti, immediately develops into Bhava Bhakti. Because if I have not chanted 16 rounds today, I will not sleep without completing my rounds. If I have not offered bhoga to Lord, I will not eat myself. That kind of bhava develops. And then ultimately, prema stage is there. When everything is Lord, belongs to Lord. Even I belong to Lord. My everything belongs to Lord. Lord is the owner, proprietor. I am just a custodian. This is prema bhakti stage. So the basic point, the key point here is association with pure devotees and surrender to Supreme Personality of Godhead. And you will remember the stages process of bhakti we had discussed earlier, from Shraddha to Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha to initiation, initiation by a spiritual pastor. Thereafter, Bhajan Kriya. Bhajan Kriya leads to Anarth Nibritti. Anarth Nibritti means unwanted material desires melt away. And when Anarth Nibritti is there, then Nishtha develops, steady faith, then Ruchi, taste for service. And then asakti, we become strongly attached to do service. And thereafter, bhava bhakti and prem bhakti. So this express leader has to be followed by us. Yes, Richa Jain Mataji, please continue.
Sahayagya praja srishta purovach prajapati anen prasvishya dhvamesh vostiv shra kamdhak. In the beginning of creation, the Lord of all creatures sent fourth generations of men and demigods along with the sacrifices for Vishnu and blessed them by saying, "Be thou happy by this yagna, because its performance will bestow upon you everything desirable for living happily and achieving liberation."
Thank you, Mataji. So, when creation was made, all the living creatures, animal and birds and human beings, everybody was created, and also demigods were created by Lord Krishna. And thereafter, also the process of sacrifice also created, sacrifice for worship of different demigods. And it was mentioned by Lord Krishna at that time that whatever you want, living entities or demigods want, that will be provided by performance of sacrifices, yajna. We know whenever there is a drought, yajna is performed. Whenever there is any other kind of calamity or disease, we perform yajna. So the respective demigods get pleased by this and they bestow upon us that the boon or benediction. So very simple. Like, we will come to cycle of yajna. So this is very clear here. Yes, Mataji. Anyone else would like to read? No.
Hare Krishna, may
yes,
I?
Please continue.
Here the word Prajapati addressing the Lord Vishnu is very significant. He is the Lord of all living creatures, all worlds and all beauties, and the protector of everyone. He created this material world to enable the conditioned souls to learn how to perform yajnas. Also called Yajnapati, yajnas, sacrifices, satisfied Lord Vishnu. In the material world, assured very comfortable life without anxiety. After completion of material existence, to enter into the kingdom of God, the material creation by Lord Vishnu is a chance offered to the conditioned souls to come back home, back to Godhead. Conditioned souls gradually become Krishna conscious and godly in all respects. But in this age of Kali, the Sankirtana Yajna, most recommended in the Vedic scriptures, introduced by the Lord Chaitanya for the deliverance of all men in this age. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So, Lord created living entities, created material nature, Prakriti, created demigods, and also gave Yajna, sacrifice. And he said, who is Yajnapati, or the enjoyer of the sacrifices? He is Lord Vishnu in the form of Krishna. Right? So, when we perform this Yajna, then of course, the Yajnapati or the oblations reached Yajnapati or Vishnu and Krishna, and he sanctions, boons, and thereby living entities remain happily in this material planet. So that is how the cycle goes on. And this material existence, by fulfilling our desires or our requirements or wants, by performing Yajna, we get a materialistic life. But this materialistic life is ultimately not the end of goal of life. The goal of life is different. Goal of life is to go back home, back to Godhead. So, and in the process of performance of Yajna, the Krishna consciousness should develop, and so that we can reach our target ultimately, or the goal, or the ultimate home. But pronunciation of slokas, mantras during performance of Yajna, performance of different kind of other holy activity or pious activity with pious environment, pious articles of home or Yajna, these are not available in these days. And you will remember, in Satyuga it was meditation, in Treta Yuga it was Yajna, in the Dwapar Yuga it was only deity worship or worshipping the Lord in the temples. And in Kali Yuga, it is only the Sankirtan Yajna. So Yajna has got different forms. Sankirtan Yajna means singing glories of Lord in a mass or mass congregation. But we Japam also, individual Japam also has got the same value. So in Kali Yuga, this Sankirtan Yajna is recommended. Yes, Mataji, read this one, then we'll shift to Bhavika Mataji.
Okay. Lord wants living entities to understand. Vedesh cha sarver aham eva vedaya. The Lord says, purpose of the Vedas is to understand him. Patim vishwa vivasatyameshwaram vedikhim. The Lord of living entities is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu. Hare Krishna.
It is, Lord wants the living entity to understand. In fact, the Lord in chapter number 15, verse 15, he has mentioned that sarvasicha aham sannivishto, hirde sannivishto, mattaha ismratir jnanam apohanam cha. I reside in the heart of each and living entity, and I provide him remembrance, smriti, jnanam, knowledge, and apohanam is tendency or capacity to forget, that is forgetfulness. So Lord says, and then he says, Vedash sarvair rahme veda, or Vedash sarvair aham eva veda, and I am the Veda, I am the knowledge of the Veda. So one has to understand what the purpose of Veda is, to understand Krishna only, or to know Krishna only. It is not to get entangled into the karma kand or ritualistic activities alone. The purpose of entire Veda is to understand or to know Krishna. And Vedvyasji, when he was writing all Vedas, he was highly dissatisfied with his work. Then he wrote Vedanta Sutra. Narad Muni, he's my spiritual master, came. Then he said, Vedvyasji said that I'm still not happy with whatever compilation work I have done. Then Narad Muni instructed him to write Srimad Bhagavatam. That was the purpose ultimate. And Srimad Bhagavatam, all of you know, deals with Krishna, his pastimes, his incarnations, expansions, their activities, and what will happen when Krishna leaves this material world, or he disappears from this, unmanifests from this world. So ultimately, knowledge of Krishna, that is which is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, is the ultimate knowledge of all Vedas. So yes, Bhavika Mataji.
The demigod, being pleased by the sacrifices, will also please you. And thus, by cooperation between men and demigods, prosperity will regain for all.
So, this is the cycle of sacrifice. Demigods, being pleased by sacrifice, will also please you. And thus, by cooperation between men and demigods, prosperity will reign for all. That means it is a bounden duty of living entities to perform yajna. Because we need, for our subsistence in the material world, we need a lot of things. We need heat, we need light, we need water, we need, you know, rains, we need some crops, some food, some air. And, you know, Krishna has appointed his ministers for each, who are in charge of each of these departments. Like Indradeva for water, you know that Vayu, Agnidev, all these demigods, they are in charge of certain departments. So living entity, by performing this yajna, they kind of seek a cooperation from the demigods, and the demigods, when pleased, they give the boon of these things. So yes, Mataji, continue. Bhavika Mataji, please continue.
The demigods are considered administrators of material affairs, supply air, light, water, etc., needed for all existence of every living entity. They reside in different parts of the body of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Pleased by the performance, non-performance of yajnas by the human being. Specific yajnas for specific demigods. However, Lord Vishnu is the chief beneficiary in all yajnas. Bhoktaram yajna, ultimate satisfaction of the yajnapati is the chief purpose. Yajnas liberate the conditioned souls from material bondages and purifies all aspects. Vedas, sanctified food stuff purifies one's very existence. Finer tissues in the memory become sanctified. And when memory is sanctified, one can think of the path of liberation, and all these combined together leads to Krishna consciousness.
Thank you, Mataji. So, key points I'll discuss here. We have already discussed some part of this thing. Bhoktaram yagitapsam. All whatever sacrifices, whatever tap or austerities are performed, ultimately enjoyer is ultimate enjoyer is Lord Krishna. Because we do all these activities for satisfaction of Yagnapati, who is Krishna himself or Vishnu. Right? And secondly, they liberate the conditioned souls from material bondage and purify all our activities. So Vedas say Ahar Shuddho, Sattva Siddho, Suddhi, Sattva Siddho, Dhruva Smriti, Smriti Lambhe, Sarva Granthi Nam Vipramoksha. That means when there is pure food, then mind becomes pure. When mind is pure, then memory becomes memory becomes good. And when memory becomes good, we are attracted toward transcendence and liberation is possible thereafter. So one has to, the message here is, one should eat only prasadam, ahar shuddho, that is food should be pure and should be consumed only after offering to Lord. We'll come to it. Furthermore, in verses it is mentioned, it becomes sin. We are eating papa, papam, or sin if we are not offering to Lord first before eating ourselves. So, eating yajnas basically, we have to do, perform yajnas for the pleasure, for the satisfaction of Lord Krishna. And for each kind of activity of benediction we want, there is certain demigod appointed by Lord. And these demigods reside in the body of Lord. You must be remembering about the universal form of Lord Krishna when he showed in 11th chapter. All demigods were seen there in the body of the Lord. So this is cycle of sacrifice. You know, Veda, the Lord Krishna is the supreme and Vedas have come from Lord Krishna and Vedas prescribe our duties for each bird and ashrama. And by performance of these prescribed duties, sacrifice is also advised as recommended as prescribed duties. When one performs sacrifices or yajna, the rains are affected. From rains, we know agriculture crops, they come up and grains are produced. And from grains, we get food. And from food, when we offer to Krishna and eat his prasad, then we are, the cycle of sacrifice is complete or yajna chakra is complete. Without offering prasadam, which has come as a benediction out of, from demigods, out of, you know, performance of prescribed duty and pleasure of demigods, the food becomes sinful to eat this food. So food becomes prasadam when it is offered to Lord. Yes, Bhavika Mataji, please continue one more. Please.
Yes. By performing of yajna, all activities become purified as it is stated in the Vedas. Ahara Shuddhau, Sattva Siddhi, Sattva Shuddhau, Dhruva Smritah, Priti Lange, Sarva Granthina, Vipra Mokshah. By performance of yajna, one effort becomes sanctified and the effort is to one's very suffering, very existence becomes purified. By the purification of existence, in the memory becomes sanctified and when memory is sanctified, one can think of the path of liberation and all these combined together with the Krishna consciousness, the great necessity of present society.
Thank you, Mataji. So this meaning of this verse is, you know, Ahar Shuddhau Tattva Suddhi Sattva Siddhau Dhruva Smriti Smriti Lambhe Sarva Granthi Nam Vipakshmo. When food is pure, mind becomes pure. When mind is pure, then memory becomes good. And when memory is good, then transcendence or the knowledge of Supreme Personality of God or Krishna consciousness develops. When that develops, one gets the path for liberation and there is freedom from bondage. So this is, Lord Krishna has already mentioned, but he doesn't want anything else other than patram pushpam phalam toyam. He wants, if a devotee offers with love and devotion, a leaf, a flower, a drop of water, or a fruit, he accepts it willingly. Yes. Who would like to read? Chanda Mataji, you raised it.
यस प्रभुजी. इष्टान भोगान ही इष्टान भोगान ही ओ देवा दास्यन्ते यज्ञ भाविताः तैर्दत्तान प्रदायेभ्यो यो भुनक्तेस्तेन एव सः. In the charge of the various necessities of life, the demigods, being satisfied by the performance of yajna, that is sacrifice, will supply all necessities to you. But he who enjoys such gifts without offering them to the demigods in return is certainly a thief. In change of the various necessity of the life, the demigods, being satisfied by the performance of yaksha. Here it is written on the blue, the pamphlet which is
it
pasted.
Is yajna, in fact, Mataji.
Okay.
Yagya, they are called it. In Hindi, we call it yagya. So,
yes, it's written, so I confused. Sacrifice will supply all necessities to you, but he who enjoys such gifts without offering them to the demigods in return is certainly a thief. Bhagavad Gita, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So, yo bhungte istena evi saha. Istena stands for thief. So, persons who eat themselves without offering to Lord apradayo ebhyo, that means those who consume the boons of benedictions of received from demigods themselves without offering to God, they are certainly thief. Now we know all these demigods are there, mothers, Lakshmi, Mother Indra, Moon, and then Saraswati, all these mothers are there. They are offering us all these kind of gifts. So we have to offer these back to gods before we consume. This is the, otherwise we are a thief, because it is given by them, we have to return to them, right? We consume for them, then we are stealing them, something which has been given by them. Yes, please read these things. This one also.
Yes,
yeah. Yes, this one.
All necessity of human society are supplied by demigods, agents of the Lord, through yajnas. None of these can be manufactured. None of the eatables, including grapes, fruits, vegetables, milk, sugar, etc., can be manufactured. Heat, light, water, etc., required to existence also for existence also cannot be created by man. Without the Supreme Lord, sunlight, moonlight, rainfall, breeze, etc., are impossible. Raw material like metal, sulfur, mercury, manganese, etc. are supplied by Lord's agents. Ultimate purpose of providing for everything by the Lord is to liberate the conditioned soul from the material struggle for existence. Those simply taking supplies from the agents of the Lord for sense gratification without due acknowledgement are thieves, getting more entangled in material existence. Such thieves lack a goal in life, ignorant of yajna's performances, punished by the law of material nature. Sankirtana yajna performs in Krishna consciousness is the easiest of all. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So we can see whatever exists around us or in our environment is a gift from Lord. He is the owner of everything. And we are using those materials, maybe chemicals, maybe, you know, some kind of building material or anything which is derived from nature. That is not ours. It belongs to Lord. So we must consider it, offering it to Lord first before we use it. But if we do not do so, then becomes istena or thief. And these days, performance of so many types of yajna is not possible. It was possible during, Treta Yuga. So when everything was so pious and holy and people knew the correct pronunciation of mantras. But this yuga, only yajna which we can perform is Sankirtana Yuga. That is the doing the japa of the holy name of Krishna. Yes. Who would like to read? Pushpa Mataji? Riya Mataji? Pushpa Mataji?
Can I read?
Yes, Mataji.
यज्ञशिष्टाशिनः सन्तो मुच्यन्ते सर्वकिल्बिषै पुञ्जन्ते ते त्वत्व अघं पापा ये पचन्ति आत्मकारणात् The devotees of the Lord are released from all kinds of sins because they eat food which is offered first for sacrifice. Others who prepare food for personal sense enjoyment verily eat only sin. Hare Krishna.
Thank you much. It is very clear. Firstly, it becomes sin. We become a thief. And secondly, it becomes now thief to eat, sin to eat something which has not been offered to Lord first. Because we are doing it for just sense enjoyment. So the cycle of sacrifice, we have seen how does it work. It is very important that everything is coming through demigods, through performance prescribed duties, through Vedic knowledge. The prescribed duties are known, and then after we do yajnas. Then when you do yajna, demigods are pleased. They give us certain boons and benedictions. They provide us the necessity of our life. And when yajna is performed, rains are there, and then rains are there, then agriculture crops are there, and grain is produced, and from grain food is produced, and from food again has to be offered because it has been produced by through the first stage through the Vedic knowledge of Vedic prescribed duties. So it has to be offered. So other, if not done so, it becomes a sin. Yes, Mataji. Patil Mataji. Your name is PC Patil Mataji.
Yeah, Pratibha Patil.
Okay, Patil. Please, sorry.
Who are Santas? Brahma Sahita 5.38. प्रेमांजन चुरित भक्त विलोचेन संत सदैव हृदयेषु विलोकयन्ति यमशाम सुंदरम अचिंत्य गुणस्वरूपम गोविंदम आदि पुरुषम तम अहम भजामि आई वर्शिप गोविंदा द प्राइमेवल लॉर्ड हु इज श्याम सुंदर कृष्ण हिमसेल्फ विद इनकंसीवेबल इन्यूमरेबल एट्रीब्यूट्स whom the pure devotees see in their heart of hearts with the eye of devotion tinged with the salve of love santas Pure devotees of the Supreme Lord, who see Lord in their heart of hearts with eyes brimmed with devotion, tinged with the salve of love, are in eternal love with Govinda, the giver of all pleasures, or Mukunda, the giver of liberation, or Krishna, the all-attractive person. They cannot accept anything without first offering it to the Supreme Person. Yajnas performed by them in different modes of devotional service, such as Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Archanam, etc., keep them always aloof from all kinds of contamination of sinful association in the material world. Others preparing food for self or sense gratification are thieves eating all kinds of sins. Sankirtan Yajna alone can rid them of these propensities, granting peace and happiness. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Bhatti. So it is very clear here. It doesn't need any explanation. This is a prayer. This is a Govinda Adi Purusham Tama Aham Bhajami. Because Krishna is the cause of all causes. He is such Chitananda Vigraha. Ishvara Param Krishna such Chitananda Vigraha. Anadir Adi Govinda, Sarva Karan Karanam. So Krishna, this is from Brahma Sahita. Krishna is cause of all causes. So this is a prayer to Lord Krishna that you have got innumerable attributes which are beyond our comprehension. And as the pure devotees see in their hearts, with devotion, you're right, with lot of love. So such people are santas, sant means sages, who are pure devotees. And they are in eternal love with you. And the yajna performed them in different modes of devotional service, such as Shravanam. We remember this Prahlad Maharaj's mantra, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Ismaranam, Pad Sevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam. Dasyam, Sakyam, Edum, Evam, Atma Nimedanam. So these forms of worship are available in Kali Yuga for all of us. And we take up any one thing, Shravanam, even listening to Srila Prabhupada messages or lectures from pure devotees or Kirtanam, any one or two of these nine processes of worship, we can seek salvation or liberation, or we can seek Krishna consciousness. Develop Krishna consciousness and ultimately reach his abode. So again, Sankirtana Yajna is very much important rather than performing all those things. So yes, Mataji, this one also. Patil Mataji.
Annad bhavati bhutani parjanyat anna sambhava yajnat bhavati parjanyo yajna karma samudbhava. All living bodies subsist on food grains, which are produced from rains. Rains are produced by performance of yajna sacrifice, and yajna is born of prescribed duties. So, Hare Krishna.
This is again a sloka which relates to the cycle of sacrifice. Yes, Mataji, this one also.
The Supreme Lord is the yajna purush, the personal beneficiary of all sacrifices. Master of all the demigods, served by all demigods as the different limbs of the body serves the whole. Demigods are automatically worshipped when Lord Krishna is worshipped. Separate worship of demigods not necessary. Demigods like Indra, Chandra and Varun assigned material affairs. Vedas direct sacrifices to satisfy these demigods. The so-pleased demigods supply air, light and water sufficiently to produce food grains. All life ultimately depends on the vegetation granted by the Lord through the demigods. Therefore, devotees of the Lord offer food to Krishna and then eat it as prasadam. Nourishes the body spiritually, vanquishes the past sinful reactions. Body immunized to all contamination of material nature. Sankirtan Yajna equally powerful in saving humans from scarcity of food supply. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So it is the same part of the cycle of sacrifice. So Yajna is described in detail here. Now, the important part of this text is last 4 points. What is the effect of prasadam? When we eat prasadam, we'll come to detailed knowledge of prasadam in chapter 17. Then what is the effect of food which is offered to Lord first and then taken as prasadam? It spreaches, it nourishes our bodily spiritually. That means our existence becomes purified and to the extent of transcendence. Vanquishes the passful reactions, all the passful activities which we have committed in this life and previous many, many lives, the reactions to them are nullified. Secondly, body becomes immunized to contamination of material nature. So we develop a higher taste, and higher taste is doing something which is pious and a mode of goodness. And all the contamination of material nature, that is the mode of goodness, ignorance, and activities which we are compelled to do, perform helplessly, otherwise under three modes, they are also eliminated. So this is but following all these rules, regulations in relation to sacrifice are not possible in this Kali Yuga. So that is why Sankirtana Yajna is the best Yajna we can perform. Indra gives us lighting, Lord Indra, thunder, storms, rains, river flows, and war. Chandra gives us juice in plant. This is also mentioned in chapter number 17, when we come to it, that by moonlight, the food gets its juiciness, its succulence, and its also sweetness. Had there not been, a sun gives us, rains, evaporation of water, yajnas, then from yajnas, clouds are formed, and the clouds give us water. Varuna, the god of all forms of water, including oceans and water present in the underworld, as well as god of universal law and celestial order, known as Rita. So this is the advantage, this is the result of worshipping different demigods who have been appointed administrators or ministers by Krishna to look after their particular department. Yes, Riya Nirjari Mataji would like to read.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Baba.
Karma brahmo brahmod bhavam vidhi brahma brahmaksara samudbhavam tasmat sarva gatam brahma nityam yagne pratisthitam. Regulated activities are prescribed in the Vedas, and the Vedas are directly manifested from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Consequently, the all-pervading transcendence is eternally situated in acts of sacrifice. Hare Krishna.
Karma brahmodabhavam vidhi brahmaksharam samudbhavam tasmat sarvagatam brahma nityam yagye pratishthitam. Regulated activities are prescribed in Vedas, and the Vedas are directly manifested from Supreme Personality of Godhead. Consequently, all pervading transcendence is eternally situated in the act of sacrifice. So we should not underestimate if we are some yajna is taking place or sacrifice is taking place. It is a transcendental activity, because whatever it has come right from the original source of all yajna is Krishna himself. And he is the enjoyer also. And he is the person, he is the entity who is making all this thing happen for our own well-being. So this is the impact of transcendence. People make love also. Sometimes yajna is performed by wastage of ghee and other material which can be used for some other person. It's not like this. It is transcendental activity. It is spiritual activity. Yes, Mother, this one also.
Hare Krishna.
Yes,
Yagnatha karma is work to be necessarily performed for the satisfaction of Krishna only. Direction for such work are laid down in the Vedas. Activity performed without the direction of the Veda is vikarma, unauthorized or sinful. Activity done under the direction of Vedas saves one from the reaction of work. Directions in the Vedas are directly manifested from the breathing of the Supreme Lord. Asya mahato bhutasya nisbastitam etat yat rig vedo yajur veda sarma shama vedo thar bangi rasha. The four Vedas, namely the rig veda, yajur veda, sama veda and atharva veda, are all emanations from the breathing of the great personality of Godhead. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So the emphasis point is here that we must act according to the Vedic injunctions, or that we should perform prescribed duties as they are prescribed in the Vedic literature or scriptures, because Vedas have directly come from Lord Krishna. All the four Vedas, they are, as I mentioned here, it is a simile, you can say that it is, they have come from the breathings of Lord Krishna, because Lord Krishna gave all directions to Vyasadeva through Narada. Narad Muni dictated this, and Vyasadeva compiled. So it is originally coming from Krishna himself. So everybody must act. If we do not act according to the Vedic injunctions or prescriptions, prescribed duties, then we are in fact doing vikarma, because this is what we mentioned earlier also. There are also third category, which is most dangerous, which should be always taken care of by us. This shall be last slide for today, because it you may continue on this.
Omnipotent Lord performs through each of his senses the action of all other senses, Brahma Samhita. He speaks by breathing air, impregnates by his eyes. Conditioned souls were impregnated into the womb of the material nature. He glanced over the material nature, fathered all living entities, gave the Vedic wisdom to conditioned souls to return home back to Godhead. Krishna consciousness, equally potent as Vedic yajnas or karmas. Those who have not followed the Vedic injunctions may adopt Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. So, as a human being, we have a material body, and only eyes are just for seeing, vision only, ears for hearing only, mouth for taste or eating only or speaking, and so many hands are for, each organ has, but it is not so with the transcendental body of Lord Krishna. He can eat with his eyes, he can hear with his mouth, he can you know, smell with his ears. He has got transcendence. He can speak by breathing here, impregnates. So now, how does living entity comes into being? That is mentioned here. After the soul leaves body, thereafter, soul, it is bound, it is not, you know, it is in a pure state. But there are, with the you know, settled body, some desires, some previous karma of previous birth, and desires, they are also along coming with the soul. So Lord Krishna looks, has a glance at the soul, right? It gives it a seed of bij, prada, pitta. Then he provides its seed or life, and the material nature, according or the prakriti, accordingly fashions the next form of life of that individual soul. Is it clear? The first, the soul is there. It has got desires and a certain material, you know, unfulfilled desires and, you know, some consciousness of previous life. Lord Krishna glances at that soul, gives a life to it, or gives a bees to it, or seed, or bij, pradapata. Lord is Krishna is called as bij, pradapata. He provides the seed to that soul, and accordingly, the material nature or the prakriti gives him the type of body. Maybe a human form, maybe a tree, maybe a hog, or maybe a monkey or a bird. So this is what is mentioned here. But the basic purpose of Vedic wisdom is to for this conditioned soul to return to back home, back to Godhead. Krishna consciousness is the highest form of yajna or karma in this age. So one must adopt Vedic injections under this Krishna consciousness. Then probably one gets rise to the level of. So let it be this, we have covered 16. We started from 9, let it be 8, one more. Evam pravartim chakram nanu vartatyatita yaha aghayur indriya ramo moham partha sa jivati. My dear Arjuna, one who does not follow in human life the cycle of sacrifice, thus established Vedas, certainly leads a life full of sin. Living only for the satisfaction of senses, such a person lives in vain. So earlier it said that one eats prasadam as a pap. The next, it was mentioned that it is a sin to seek for self-enjoyment without offering the boons or benefits of food or anything to Lord Krishna. And now it is very clearly mentioned here that this life, human life, becomes waste. So one must use this human life for performing sacrifice. And the sacrifice in last verses has been clarified that it is only the Naam Sankirtana sacrifice is possible in this age. No other sacrifice is possible because of so many factors. We have just mentioned that our life is short, our memory is short, and also mind is always agitated and under certain kind of impulses, which we are forced to help, which we are forcefully held to perform helplessly under control of three modes of material nature. So we end here. The next section is from 17 to 35. We'll take it up tomorrow. Please fill in the attendance. I have posted the attendance link now. So this is summary, and then we come to section 4 tomorrow. So we are going to have some kind of devotees. We are going to have some kind of change our in our classes. From 1st April, it shall be Monday to Friday. Saturday and Sundays, you will get a weekend off so that you may prepare accordingly and do other activities if you want to during that weekend. So we can continue Monday to working days only, 7 to same time. Please fill in the attendance. And if there is any question or doubts regarding today's, we are going a bit slow so that proper understanding develops. Everybody is able to get the basic philosophy and also the purpose of this session. Any questions, any Mataji or Prabhuji's would like to? Hare Krishna. If there is no question or doubt or correction or recommendation,